Ugh, my program crashed again. What do I do with this? I don't know how to interpret this gibberish. If you've been in that situation before, yeah, I feel ya. But fear not. Exceptions are actually more of our friend than our enemy when it comes to debugging more often than not. In today's video, I'm gonna attempt to demystify what exceptions are within Java. A lot of times people overcomplicate it, but really all it is error handling. Think about it. If something happens in your program that it doesn't expect, or let's say a user gives you some bad data, you need to be able to handle that as an error case. Let's pull up a definition quick. According to Oracle, who's the maintainer of Java, an exception is an event which occurs during the execution of a program that disrupts the normal flow of the program's instructions. To better understand how that definition actually relates to our code, let's generate some exceptions. So here in IntelliJ, we're gonna make a new project. We'll call it exceptions, and we'll create the new project. All right, let's open our main class that the IDE generated for us, remove the hello world. So let's start by making a string array. And let's give it one string. So if you recall, if I want to access hello, what I would do is I would do my array and I would start at index 0. And I'll make sure this runs just to make sure there's no funny business. So element 0 points to the first element in our array, and that's where we get the hello here. If I try to look at a different element other than 0, such as 1, then now badness is going to start happening. Uh-oh, here's our exception. Exception in thread main Java lang array index out of bounds exception index 1 out of bounds for length 1 at main.main. Okay, what in the world is going on here? Let's break this down a little bit. First thing I want to say is a lot of people look at this, and by this I'm referring to this piece of information right here. This is what's called a stack trace. They look at this and think, what the heck, I don't know how to work with this. There's way too much information here. And I would agree, there is a lot of information here to digest. So let's break it down little by little. First word there is exception. So that's what we're talking about. An exception occurred, meaning that an error case occurred in our program, and now our program is handling the exception as best as it can, which in our case is the program entirely crashes. We're in thread main. We haven't talked about threads very much yet. This is basically the main thread that enters when the Java virtual machine begins our program. So the main point of execution is hitting this exception. That's what you can think of here. Java.lang. So we've talked about how we have java.util sometimes to import data from, such as scanner and random. Java.lang is another package within the Java language that is implicitly used. And now we have this array index out of bounds exception class. I can actually click on this and I can see the array index out of bounds exception.java file if I really wanted to peek through this within the IDE. There's a lot of information here. I'm not going to look at it very much. But the point is, the IDE makes it so that you can reference where things are happening pretty clearly. Index 1 out of bounds for length 1. So what does that mean? Index is 1 right here. And that is out of bounds for the length of our array, my array, who has a length of 1. So we talked about how indexes start at 0. Therefore, the last element in array has to be the length of the array minus 1. So that would, in our case, would be 1 minus 1, which is 0. So that's what this is saying. And we even get a line number of where it's happening. At main, which is our main class, dot main, which is our main method, main.java, line 4. So we can see exactly where our error is occurring here. Just to show that the error message does change when we change array indexes, I'm gonna change this to 3 and show how the array index out of bounds exception message updates. There we can see index 3 out of bounds for length 1. Same thing, main.java, line 4. Very good. So if I'm looking at this stack trace, this actually tells me a host of information. If you come from a different programming language like C and you get a seg fault, you're often kind of scratching your head wondering, where'd this seg fault come from? I don't know how to work with this. Well, in Java, you're actually in luck. If you triggered an exception, you can trace down pretty quickly what the originator of the exception is and why it is an exception. Next, I'm going to demonstrate how a stack trace builds up as you nest more and more functions. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have my main function call a whole bunch of functions lower, and then I'll show that the stack trace reflects that where the actual exception is happening. All right, so how I updated the code is my main function is calling function 1, who then calls function 2, who then calls 3, 4, and then 5, etc., as you can see there. So now if I run this, we'll see how the stack trace and our exception error message changes. And would you look at that? We have very detailed information on the full set of nested functions that we called in order to get to our exception. What you want to look for in Java is the most recent element that's still within your code where the exception is getting triggered. So in our case, that's main.java line 20. And we can see right here, we are trying to access the array element 3 when that doesn't exist. If I click on the bottom entry, it brings me to line 3, which isn't super helpful. If I keep going up the stack, then it finally brings me to where my actual exception is happening. All right, so that's how we trigger an array index out of bounds exception. Let's go ahead and trigger a different type of exception within function 4 before we hit function 5. Let's make an integer array. We'll call it massive array. And in Java, with this syntax, you can indicate the number of elements within an array you want it to create. So instead of just 10 integers, I'm going to have it make a billion integers. And we'll see how the code handles this. All right, and this is what we call the dreaded out of memory error. So this is saying an exception, again, within our main thread, an out of memory error this time, and it says Java heap space. We haven't talked too much about the difference between the stack and the heap. Basically, what you can think of it as is the heap is what is used to allocate things with the new operator here, so new object instances like arrays. And what this is saying is that there is not enough Java heap space to accommodate a billion integers. So we're going to bomb out at line 16 when we're trying to create that massive array, and it's not going to work. Okay, so that's the second type of exception that we've talked about. Let's talk about one more, and we'll go ahead and do it within function number 2. This time, I'm going to set a string equal to null, and now I want to get something out of this string. And there you have it, null pointer exception, often abbreviated as NPE. This is the dreaded exception that many Java developers deal with on a day-to-day basis when they're making code robust. What a null pointer exception means is that you're trying to do something on an object reference, such as a string, and the reference that you're pointing to is pointing to nothing, aka null. So you might ask, what is the length of null? Well, it's not defined, and that's why this null pointer exception gets thrown, and it even tells us some of the details of it right here. We can't invoke the string.length method here, because our string variable is null. And again, the stack trace tells us where this happens. The entry point of our code is the main method here. That's where it all starts. But we want to look at the most recent part of the stack trace, which is still within our code, which in this case is main.java line 11. So now we've generated three different types of exceptions. I want to show a few other things within this code that you might find interesting. The first thing is I've got three warnings. If I highlight all my warnings here, the first one is right here. Method invocation length will produce null pointer exception. So this is the IDE telling us, hey, if you're going to run this code, this is going to throw a null pointer exception. IDEs aren't always smart enough to catch when an NPE might happen, but this is a great example of using the tools in our favor because the Java code compiles just fine. Then when we run it, we get this null pointer exception, whereas the IDE is giving us this warning that, hey, when you run this code, you're going to get a null pointer exception. So listen to those IDE warnings. They're often quite good. Here's an example of why the warnings don't tell you everything. This case is just telling you that you're not using the variable, which is an issue, but I wasn't trying to demonstrate not using the variable. I was trying to demonstrate an out-of-memory error. The IDE isn't picking that up, but at the same time, I don't know if I would expect it to, because that would require intimate knowledge of what the target is that we're actually running our code on. Then this third warning is interesting. If I hover over the index, it says array index is out of bounds. Again, the IDEs are pretty smart, so it caught two out of our three exceptions, and the third one really just being, hey, the system didn't have enough memory to allocate for Java. So all things considered, the IDE is doing awesome here, giving us warnings when it thinks an exception might happen. Now, the last thing I want to mention is if you want to write good Java code, you will do what's called exception handling. And that is you write your code in such a way that when certain types of exceptions get thrown, you might catch them at different levels of your program, depending on how you can handle them. Exception handling, properly doing that, that's a topic for a whole nother video. I just wanted to introduce that the goal of this video was to talk about what exceptions are, and in a future video we can talk about what exception handling is and how we properly handle exceptions when they get encountered in our code. There you have it. That's exceptions in a nutshell. What I covered in this video is the concept of what an exception is and how they work in our code, as well as how to read a stack trace. In future videos, I'll talk about things such as making our own custom exceptions, handling exceptions properly, and using other elements of the language such as the try, catch, finally statements, and additional things that go into proper exception handling. If you liked this video, please do hit that like button. If you haven't subscribed yet and you're enjoying the content, please do take a moment to hit that subscribe button. Thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video, and I hope to see you next time. Take care.